Hello, my name is Venique Harley, and I am the Director of Human Relations and Organizational Development with 1890 Research and Extension here at South Carolina State University. Employers and employees have a shared responsibility for safety during the coronavirus pandemic. We've got to adjust to our new normal, and we need all hands on deck as we look at new ways and proactive ways to be safe while at work. As we prepare to come back to work, it's important that we follow the CDC guidelines. The CDC has done an excellent job establishing what things that we need to do to stay safe as employees. First and foremost, know the signs and symptoms of the coronavirus. If you have a cough, a fever, aches, chills, sore throat, if you lose your ability to taste and smell, contact your physician immediately. And then most importantly, stay home from work. The best line of defense also from preventing the spread of coronavirus is to constantly wash your hands for at least 20 seconds. Soap and water is the best defense for cleaning our hands, but also you can use hand sanitizer with an alcohol concentration greater than 60% if soap and water is not available. Remember to wear your face mask whenever you're in group gatherings or if you're working in office common spaces. And also, your mask should be sure to cover your nose and your chin. There are three ways that the coronavirus enters the body: through the eyes, the nose, and the mouth. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth as much as possible to prevent the virus from entering your body. If you need to cough, use your elbow and cough into your elbow. And ensure that you always wear a mask whenever you are outside of your workspace. As employees enter the workplace, it's important that you remember to stay 6 feet apart and abide with those social distancing guidelines. It's also critical that we find alternative ways to greet each other and avoid handshakes and hugs. Let's talk about office safety. Now it's time to declutter and clean in your office spaces so that employees can do deep cleaning and sanitizing each day. It's going to be important to wipe down your doorknobs, your handles, desktops, light control panels, telephones, keyboards and mouses, and copy machines, any items that's being touched often and frequently throughout the day. If multiple individuals share workspaces, employers may want to consider rearranging work offices so that staff can maintain 6 feet distances in the work environment, and also place signage throughout the work sites. Some groups may even go as far as to consider staggered working shifts and days so that it limits employee contact in the office. Also, avoid visiting colleagues' offices. I know this is gonna be a challenge, but it's gonna be very important that we maintain that social distance. And if you must visit someone's office, be sure to wear a mask. Limit as many in-person meetings as possible, and use telephone and video conferencing and web-based meeting platforms. It's the safest way to continue to conduct business. Navigating around the work office is also going to be important. We should use stairs and limit the use of elevators. If someone is in the stairwell and you need to enter, allow that person to exit the stairwell before you enter. If you need to use the elevator, only allow one person in the elevator at one time. And also consider bringing a pen with you so that you can touch the button with the pen and not use your finger. Taking care of yourself is more important now than ever. We must seek ways to stay active and positive. Continue your daily medication regimens, eat a well-balanced diet, and most importantly, remember to rest. Throughout the pandemic, continue to monitor websites from OSHA, the CDC, and the World Health Organization for tips so that you and your family can remain safe. We will need to continue to adjust to our new posture at work to remain safe, but we can do this. We're resilient and we'll come out better and stronger. For more information about 1890 Research and Extension, please visit our website,